here to celebrate today's African child. As one who is a leader today in this country, having been supported as a child through child sponsorship program. I was a sponsored child by World Vision, and that's how I acquired my education. And today, as we celebrate the African child, we are saying all is possible when we all stand up for the African child and for the child of the world. Ladies and gentlemen, all protocol observed, I once again greet you in the name of our Lord, of our God, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. We are gathered here this morning, rather now this afternoon, to commemorate the Day of the African Child, a day where we pause to reflect on issues relating to our children. It is a day that we should pause as individuals, and particularly as faith communities, to reflect on the role we are all called to play in the war against HIV and TB. The Day of the African Child is important, as it is a day for us to care, educate, counsel, empower our children, including orphans and children living with or affected by HIV and TB. The Bible in the book of Matthew, chapter 18, verse 10, says, "See that you do not despise one of these little ones. For I tell you that in heaven there are angels who always see the face of my Father in them." In addition, Psalms 127 verse 3 says, "Behold, children are a heritage from the Lord. The fruit of the womb a reward." These two verses serve to remind us that we need to take care of our children, including ensuring their access to medication as their inherent rights. This year, the theme is the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development for Children in Africa, Accelerating Protection, Empowerment, and Equal Opportunity for Children in Africa. To achieve these ambitious targets, there is need for everyone to ensure that we do our very best and put all our commitments in earnest to programs that will enhance the protection and the guidance of the African child. Ladies and gentlemen, there can be no doubt this meeting should encourage, challenge, should encourage, inspire, empower, and for better equip us to control and to confront many challenges ahead to achieve the global targets for providing 1.6 million children and 1.2 adolescents with antiretroviral therapy and the TB treatment by the end of 2018. We would like to call on the national and county governments and development partners and the religious fraternity to increase the funding, time allocated for research in HIV and TB and resources. In addition, pharmaceutical companies must ensure that children bred HIV and TB regimens are available in Kenya, as this is one of the key challenges facing the treatment and care of pediatrics. Further, we recognize the critical role played by faith communities in child protection and care in this country. It is my sincere hope that we shall open our doors to all to offer refuge for the ones who need such support. Our faith communities should be a place of refuge and a hope where every child is accepted without discrimination and without any stigma at all. Let us all join. Let us all join to end pediatric HIV and TB in Kenya. The faith communities must continue to play a key role in ensuring that every child enjoys the best attainable state of physical, mental, and spiritual health. It is our prayer that the current and recurring strikes by health practitioners will be addressed both by the national and county governments and be brought to an end, including the Ministry of Health and the practitioners themselves. It is also our hope and prayer that we address issues of food security in this country to increase nutrition, to alleviate the untold suffering by children and the poor households and other patients that who need, particularly those who need the greatest care, that is to be provided. May we all stand up to be counted, and to be counted as caregivers, and not for self-gain, but as one who are doing it out of duty, call for duty, and under the direction of God, the author and preserver of our lives. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forever, as a people, as a community, as children of this beloved country and the world at large. Thank you, and God bless you.